Reference, word of the Lord.
Romans.
Letter to Romans, chapter 6. Romans, chapter 6. Romans 8. There's therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. We adore you, Lord. Praise your name for another blessing, word, deliverance in the name of the Jesus, that your word can now speak to our hearts. We pray in the name of Jesus. Amen. Please be seated. This letter was written by Paul to the Church of Rome. So it was written to the church. And Paul, he spoke many things in this letter. He said that we are baptized in Christ Jesus with the baptism of his death. So he says to the church that the church was baptized in Jesus Christ with the baptism of his death. And he says more. We are grieved by Jesus with the baptism of the death. So Jesus resurrected from the death. So he was crucified Christ. So the body of the sin is undone. So we don't serve more the sins. So we're baptized in his death. We were known and with him, so the body of the sin can be undone. So we know when the body, when it's dead, it's with the time it degrades. He no longer exists, and that's what Paul was saying to the church. Because those who is dead is justified. It's justified by the sin. And if we die with Christ, we believe that with him we will live. So Paul speaks about that. He speaks about the death and the baptism of Christ. And then we were known by Christ. And the way that Christ resurrected for the glory. So we were dead with Christ. So we will have to resurrect ourselves in a new divine life. And now in chapter 8, this song talks about that a little bit. In the chapter 8, he says that therefore, brethren, we have been crucified by Christ, we have been buried by Christ, and we have resurrected by Christ. So at this exact moment, that the word of Lord is live and is for now. It's not for today, it's not for yesterday, it's not for tomorrow. And it says, if today you listen to my voice, When Jesus talks to the bad person, he says, today you will be with me in the eternity. Don't let your salvation for tomorrow. Don't leave it for tomorrow. Just do it today. It's now. In this exact moment. And he says that, so there is therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus. The word speaks about judgment, because his love and his judge and justice. If you look at the Old Testament, you see the judgment of Jesus in the flesh. If you look at the New Testament, you see the judgment of the Lord for the flesh. For now, so no condemnation. There will be no condemnation for those who are in Jesus Christ. So before, there was a condemnation. And when we look at the Bible, the word says that the salary of the death is that sin is the death, and the freedom is the eternal life in Jesus. But who sin? All of them. All of us sin. But it was taken from the glory of God. So we all are under a sentence, under condemnation, and no one is condemned to do the good things. They are condemned to do the bad things, the bad works, for its bad conduct, for its bad way to live. And in the case of Jesus, we are condemned by our sins, because of our sins, and all with no exceptions, sin. There's not one just person, not even today and not even in the past. When Sodoma and Gomorrah were going to be destroyed, Abraham interceded for that city because there was a family member of him. So you're going to destroy the... 50 just... If there's 40 people that just, I won't destroy. If there's 30, I'm not going to destroy the city. 20, 10. If there's 10 people that just, I'm not going to destroy the city. So there was no one and the city was destroyed. The judgment of the God. But the word says that there is therefore no condemnation. There will be no condemnation. Now Jesus came to the world. Now God took a decision in our favor, in our benefit. John 3:16, because God loved the world in a way that he sent his only Son, for those who believe in him cannot be condemned, but can have eternal life. So, brethren, we can see that the sin condemns the mankind. He sentences the man to death. But there is an antidote, a medicine for the sin. No one goes to hell. All go to heaven if they want. They all go to hell if they want. You go to hell if you want. If you don't want, you're not gonna go to hell, because it's not the sin that's gonna take you to hell. It's the rejection of the love of God that's gonna take you to hell. Because if the sin takes you to hell, we're all gonna go to hell. But why we know we're not going to hell? Because we accept it. Jesus as our only our Savior. So you have the freedom to do it. If you want to go And here in the United States, there's a AA, there's a Anonymous Alcoholics. If you want to drink, that's your problem. And if you want to stop drinking, that's my problem. I know that because my brother was like that. And it's like that. If you want to be under the condemnation, that's your problem. You have the right. But if you want to go to heaven, that's our problem now. Because the church is the body of Christ. And Paul says that there's and Paul says, therefore now no condemnation to those who are in Jesus Christ. So there was a for the death of Jesus, we were delivered from this condemnation, from this judgment, from this sentence of death. But you can say, now I'm saved. Save once, save forever. That's not what the word is saying. It's not what the word is saying. If you look the Bible, from Genesis to Revelation, it's not that. When the word says, believe in Jesus and you will be saved. Yes or no? And you will be. And you'll be. If you continue to believe, because Jesus is the way. Hallandale. I'm going from here to Hallandale. But if I stop in Sunrise, I'm not going to Hallandale. Am I going to get there? No, I'm not going to get there. Why am I not going to get there? Because I stopped. So Jesus is the way. He's the truth. He's the life. No one comes to the Father if it's not through me. So if I go to this road, I have to continue to the end of it. And Paul says, be faithful until, and then you will receive the crown of life. No condemnation to those who are in Christ Jesus, in present tense, are. It's not for those who were, or not for those who will be, because tomorrow doesn't exist. I'm 55, I never seen the tomorrow come. It's always today. Tomorrow is today. It never gets to tomorrow. Because this song says tomorrow could be late. No condemnation to those who are in Jesus Christ. For those who are in Christ, in what it is be in Christ. Jesus comes to the disciples, and this is my bread, this bread is my flesh, my body, and this is the wine is my blood, and those who drink and eat this will be will have part with me. I'm with them, and them in me. So what is it to be in Christ? What is to be in Christ? I'm in Christ. When am I in Christ? When I'm not in the flesh. The true believer will adore the Father, the Spirit, and the truth. God is the Spirit. And a condemnation. There's no condemnation for those who are in Jesus Christ, who do not walk according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. So he's saying that there are people that are in Christ because they receive Christ, because they recognize the baptism of the death through Christ. But there are some that walk with the flesh, and some that walk without the Spirit. And there's no condemnation for those who are with the Spirit. But for those who walk according to the flesh, they will continue under the condemnation. That's why Jesus, when he dies to undo the flesh. Because the word says that those who walk according to the flesh, for those inclined, it's unfriendly with God. For those who walk according to the flesh, it's unfriendly against God. He's the enemy of God. And some enemy of God will inherit the reign of God. No. Jesus comes to the disciples and says, "You're not my servants." And the song says, "Jesus, my friend." So walk according to the flesh is to be enemy of God.
It says,
the weak to the flesh is the unfriendly against the God. So there's for not to be no condemnation in my life. I accepted Jesus and received the promise of salvation. So I can reach that promise. I cannot walk according to the flesh, according to to your own rational, with my understanding, with my own feelings, with my own thinking, with my own act, my attitudes, and my acting again. For not to have condemnation, I have to walk in spirit. A servant, a man, came to Jesus, Nicodemus. And Jesus told him something. He was not understanding anything. Maybe there was somebody here that's not understanding anything. So he came to Nicodemus. What's born on the flesh is flesh. But what's born in the spirit, it's spirit. So when we accept Jesus, we pass through the new birth. We're born again. Just like said in the what I was before, I'm not now. Before I have accepted Jesus to go through the baptism and be resurrected, I used to walk according to the flesh. And all of us here walked according to the flesh, because that was the only thing we had. But now that we met Jesus to accept his project, in our lives we cannot walk according to the flesh anymore. We have to walk according to the Spirit. And Jesus, right there in the beginning of the book of John and the Gospel of John, and God, so we were born for the projects of God, for the reign of God, for the will of God, for the grace of God, for the love of God, for the gift that He gave us, for the. So Isaiah.
And
Jesus is a gift, the vapor. And when we receive this gift, and we keep this present in our life, this gift in our life, there's no other condemnation, no death sentence, because now we don't walk according to the flesh, because all the flesh was undone. It was destroyed. The flesh disappeared. Because The flesh is weak. It has to disappear. And says, but according to the Spirit. But what is to walk according to the Spirit? First thing, walk according to the Spirit. It's to walk according a project of God to your life.
Though
there was a servant of the Lord that used to walk with Jesus. Tomé. You said that you're the word. I'll go to the Father. But I don't know what the way is. He did not know. Tomé. Where to walk. There's a verse in the Bible that says, and you will hear from behind you a voice saying, this is the way. For you cannot deviate to the right or to the left. So when we hear the voice of the Holy Spirit, we don't deviate from the way. We don't get out the project of the way. We walk according to the Spirit. So we hear, if we don't listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit, we will deviate. Deviate from the right to the left. And if to the right, you will. Because 1,000 will. When you're wrong, you fall. Your conscience that you went to the left, that you sinned, that you fell down. 1,000 will fall, but to the right will fall 10,000. Oh, yes. Those who have the reason, because they're according to the flesh, they will fall more. That's the women's song. Saul killed 1,000. David, 10,000. Why? If you look, the Bible says David was anguished. And from that moment, the Holy Spirit, Sansão, and the Holy Spirit empowered Sansão, and he would kill, and the Holy Spirit took over David, and David went over there and killed the giant. And in the following verse, that from the moment the Holy Spirit left Sansão. 1 Samuel, it's written. That's why Sansão was able to beat 1,000, and David was able to beat 10,000. So walk according to the flesh. It's an enemy of God. And it's under a sentence, a judgment. It's not saved. But walk according to the Spirit that will reach from the Lord the salvation. Why? Because the law of the Spirit of life, because Christ Jesus delivered me from the sin of death. So when we walk on the Spirit, we're free, we're delivered of the sin and consequently from the death. And when I don't walk on the Spirit, I cannot free myself from sin and consequently won't free myself from death. And there's a verse in the Bible that says, but if someone doesn't have the Christ Spirit, so to be sure of our salvation, the Spirit of Christ has to be in us. Or not. This Holy Spirit lives in us. So those who walk according to the Spirit, are guided by the Spirit, there's no condemnation for that. There's no condemnation for me because I'm walking according to the Spirit. But if I'm not according to walking according to the Spirit, I'm still under the condemnation, the judgment. So it's the new life under the grace. And it's exactly that that we have to comprehend it, to understand. It's to live under the grace, under the love, under the mercy of God, because that mercy is the cause of us not being consumed, that delivers us from all the condemnation. That's why Paul says that. So there is therefore now no condemnation for those who are in Jesus Christ, who do not walk according to the flesh. For what the law could not do in the weak. And he talked about slavery. What is to be a slave? A person that has an addiction is a slave. Is a slave of something, yes. But when the Lord created the man, did he create the man to be a slave? Yes or no? No. So when the Lord created Adam, so he creates the animal so Adam can see. And God said to him, and you will, and you're going to dominate. You're going to dominate everything. For you to dominate everything. And when you have an addiction, you are dominated. And a person that's dominated does not have the freedom. Slave does not have a freedom. And Paul says that. A spirit of slavery. We don't receive the spirit of slavery. We receive the Spirit of God. The Spirit of peace, console. The Spirit of justice. Because we are justified by the precious blood of Jesus. And you don't have to be afraid. You don't have to be afraid. Why won't you have to be afraid? Because big is what in us. Why did David win that battle? Because the Holy Spirit was with him, was in him. And what about the church? How did the church win the battles? The church wins the battle, the sin, the flesh. How does the church beat that? It's by the Spirit of God. So there's no reason to be afraid because we receive the Spirit. Because we plead for the Father, and He helps us, and He comes to support us. When David was there to bear or the lion, he spoke about, I'd grab the lion, but the Lord would deliver me. And as the Lord delivered me from the lion and the bear, the Lord will deliver me from this Philistine. You go back a little bit, because David was he was anointed. David was anointed, and when he has the Spirit with us, amen. Thank you. your name. Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Protect a child, and then when you're protecting a child, there were some bad people, and those bad people would kidnap this man, they would transport him to another place, and he was a kidnapping, and but tonight. That this man was in a closed place, you know. And then the only solution for him to deliver, to free him from that situation, was the Lord. And because of the child, the Lord would send an angel, deliver the man from that situation. What does the Lord want to say with that? A man that's in jail and being conducted by the enemy. But that this man has a child. And so one day Jesus was born in his life, in his heart. But the servant of the Lord one day allowed Jesus to be born. And accepted Jesus as the only Savior, he cannot walk according to the flesh. He cannot be conducted by the man. He's a bad person, the enemy. And the only way for the Lord to deliver him, it's through the Lord. You know what Jesus says? If the Son will deliver us, we truly be free. It's the same Son that's going to deliver you from tonight, from this situation. And this prison can mean a lot of things. Making you do things you don't want to do. Preventing you to be in the present. What the enemy put as a barrier. But the Lord is removing this barrier and opening all the doors so you can have the freedom to serve the Lord. Not walking again according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. And when we walk according to the Spirit, nothing, no condemnation. And the verse 14 says, for as many as are led by the Spirit of God, these are sons of God. So who is the Son of God? Those who are guided by the Holy Spirit. Those who are guided by the Holy Spirit are Son of God. And walk in the Spirit. And so there's no condemnation. Amen? Glorification. And then we're going to sing that song. Dear Lord, we glorify, we praise you, Lord, because one day you chose us, you called us by the name, and in that moment we were no longer condemned. When we confess our sins, our life was transformed. We pray your name, Lord, we praise your name, O Lord, because your power and your love is huge. You're holy, holy. Tonight, we would like to give you all the gratitude to express our love. We want to express our feeling of gratitude and all that you've done. Blessed be your name, Lord, for all and forever. In the name of Jesus, amen. Let's stand up, please. You can give us a blessing week, keeping, delivering from all the bad, opening all the doors, and giving us a great experience, Lord. Please return to your love, to our houses. We pray in the name of Jesus. In your name we say, in the wonderful grace of Lord, the love of God, our Father, and the sweet consolation of the Holy Spirit can be poured upon us. Now forever, amen. Our service has ended. You that you are with us through Zoom or here, if you like to have an assistant, the brethren will be here to assist you. Amen. Remember the church that this we have a special program. There's going to be a meeting with the young people at Hallandale. At 10 a.m. there will be the Sunday Bible School. in special next week, next Sunday. We'll be in Hallandale. In Hallandale. At 10 a.m. After the Sunday Bible School, there will be, this will be a gospel without frontiers for all the young guys, for all the church as well. And in the afternoon, there's going to be evangelization around the church. And there's going to be a service at 6 p.m. where all the young from Pompano, Bradenton, Orlando, and the Hallandale will participate. Amen? There will be 3 days of consecration for the young, for all the church are invited to participate. Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, from midnight to 9, a consecration, a fasting. Thursday, there will be a special early dawn via Zoom. Pastor Ronaldo will send the link to all of us who wish to participate. Amen. To all, peace the Lord. Any other information?
That's it.
Tuesday, we have the meeting. That will be presential here Tuesday. If anybody would like to have a prayer, please raise your hand and we will come to you. We'll give you the amen.